Now the topic is Hall effect. Hall effect transducer. How it works? We will see. Okay, that is what the definition. The Hall effect transducer are used for measuring the magnetic field by converting into an EMF. How it is converting into an EMF? So here the magnetic field, whatever magnetic field is there, it is converting into an EMF. Yes, when you are passing one current, the magnetic field, whenever you pass, the electrons, the charges will accumulate on one side. So actually the charges will try to oppose it. See, in this nature everything will oppose. So whenever you do an external magnetic field, the charges, the electrons in the magnet, in the conductor, in this strip, in this conductor, will align themselves. Align themselves. So in this conductor, they will align themselves to give some magnetic, to oppose this magnetic field. To oppose this magnetic field, we are taking, let this phase align with positive and this phase is aligned with negative. You will get an equivalent voltage because of this transverse magnetic field. When magnetic field is not there, you won't get. You will get zero. So it is how much magnetic field you increase the magnetic field strength. You increase it, this voltage also will increase. So it depends upon the density of the magnetic field. Now so read the definition. Now let's see. The Hall effect are used to measure the magnetic field, yes, by converting into an EMF. So we are converting into an EMF. The transducer converts. What is the transducer? This transducer converts the magnetic field into an electric quantity. Exactly correct. Whenever you magnetic field you increase, electric quantity other side it is increasing. Okay, which is easily measurable by using your any meter. Analog voltage you take, digital voltage you take, you can measure. What is the principle of Hall effect transducer? If the current carrying strip, same, now what I explained, you can see this. If the current carrying strip, that strip we have taken of thickness T, if the conductor is placed in the magnetic field, then EMF develops and the edges. So yes, EMF is generated, I think EMF is generated at the edges of the conductor. How much? The magnitude of the voltage depends upon the density of the flux. This property is a Hall effect. On this Hall effect, current sensor works. Okay, mute yourself. Okay, so from the this statement you can read, you can understand. Now the EMF generated depends upon the current. Yes sir, if you increase the current, the EMF will increase. If you increase the magnetic field, yes, the EMF will increase. Directly proportional to the current and directly proportional to the B, magnetic field. And inversely proportional to thickness. You should take thin one, then you will get more EMF. So KIB, mute yourself. Komal, 486, time pass fellow. The I is the current, B is the magnetic flux, and T is the thickness. Okay. You can now, what are the applications you check? Okay. Applications are there, used in a, like, so displacement you can measure in this, current you can measure in this, magnetic field you can measure in this, power you can measure in this. How? Just different diagrams are there. Magnetic field you can measure, yes I said to you, magnetic field you can measure. The more is the magnetic field, the more is the voltage. Voltage is directly proportional to the magnetic field. By measuring the EMF, you can calculate the magnetic field. If you increase the magnetic field, voltage will increase. So this is a measure of magnetic field. And one more, measure of displacement. Here you see what he did, ferromagnetic plate he took. He is changing this ferromagnetic plate. The moment if you change this, yes, magnetic field will change. Why? Because the field strength is very, very near. When you are near to this permanent magnet, If you are going away from the permanent magnet, field strength will decrease. Okay, so field strength depends upon this displacement also. So the if you change the displacement, magnetic field B is changing in E is equal to KIB by T. So B is changing, you can calculate the, so this displacement we are able to convert into electric field because of the change in the magnetic flux. Yes sir, you can imagine, you take a magnet, you keep one conductor nearby to the magnet, it pulls it harder, you keep away, it pulls slowly. So distance, when you change the distance, yes, magnetic field strength will decrease. Magnetic field strength will decrease means EMF you can generate. Measurement of current, of 100% it is easy to measure the current. Yes, we have seen, here only we explained. If you are changing the current, EMF will change. That is a measure. In the formula also you can see, it is directly proportional to I. As I changes, E changes. Then it is your thing that how to calibrate, you have to calibrate your instrument. By calibrating, you can able to measure the current and magnetic field and the displacement. So these are the applications. Power means just voltage you can calculate and current you can calculate, multiply, you can calculate the power. Okay, so then one problem was a simple direct problem. In this problem, if you see, coefficient K is given, B is given, and thickness is given, current is given, voltage they are asking, just substitute and you will get the voltage. Okay. This is about Hall effect sensor, very important. If you want, I will explain. Only one working principle is, try to understand the working principle. Okay, once again, I will try to explain you